Hello, my happy fellow YouTubers! This is Marcelina. How are you guys? What a beautiful day today! Look at that! It's sunny days! Springtime, guys! Springtime! So get ready with your gardening tools, prepare your garden, let's grow some vegetables. Also, I'm going to give a shout to the Philippines. Oh my goodness, you guys are awesome! You are the second largest viewers of my channel. So my number one is United States. Thank you, my friend. Second is in the Philippines and third is in India. So thank you, my friends from India, for watching my gardening channel. So I will cut this short. I just have few copy. That's why I am too much pumped up. So in this video, guys, I'm going to follow up with you with the seed germination, because I promise that once this is germinate, I'm going to give you an update. So come on in, let's get inside. Alright guys, this is a follow-up video of our seed germination. I promise I'm going to give you an update once the seeds germinate. So this is the result. We germinated the desert roses when we applied neem powder into our soilless media. Neem powder is not only preventing fungus gnats or dumping off seedlings, it also provides nitrogen boost to the young plant, like what you see here. Look at this baby plant, guy. Look at that, how healthy it is. The leaves are green and majority of the seeds are sprouted, and some seeds just sprouting, like what you see here. Look at how beautiful is that. And I'm going to show you the desert roses that I transferred. So these are the desert roses I transferred into the pot. I still applied the neem powder. I spread on the leaves, and as you see, the leaves are healthy. It's a little bit leggy, like what you see here, because the plant did not get enough sunlight. So I'm going to place this under the fluorescent light. We also germinated peppers when we germinate the when we germinated desert roses. So these are the Carolina Reapers that I germinated in this tray. So these are the Carolina Reapers in the second trays. Have you noticed, guys, that the first tray, they are the same papers. We germinated the same days and we applied neem powder the way we apply in the desert roses. Have you noticed that the plant's height is different than the height of the first tray? And I'm going to show you the last tray that I planted peppers. Okay, so this is the last tray we germinated peppers, and as you notice here, these plants are taller and bigger than the other peppers, and I was wondering why these peppers grow differently than the others. And the only thing I can figure out is that maybe the seeds, because the bigger the seeds you germinate, the bigger is the plant. And probably that is the only one answer I could come out, because they are treated the same way. We give them a powder, neem powder, and then we germinated them at the same time, but they grow differently. So if you have a better answer, guys, why this paper is bigger than the other, write that comment and share that with us. So I'm going to transfer this. I'm also going to follow up with you the papers we grow in Fagpanics. All right, guys, before we transfer our papers into its pot, I'm going to introduce you the two products we use here. We use the neem powder. We also use the Mycoplas. Now, prior to the seed germination, you need to apply 1 teaspoon of neem powder, sprinkle on the top surface of your soilless media, and place the seeds. The neem powder is going to protect the propagation site against pathogen, protecting that fungus gnats and dumping off seedlings. During the process of seed germination and growth development, when your seedlings start to develop the first true leaves, this is the time that you are going to introduce the neem again in the liquid form. Take 1 teaspoon of neem, mix in a gallon or a quart of water, and place in your sprayer and spray the seedlings. This is going to protect the seedlings against insects, pests, and fungus while giving nitrogen to your plant. Now,
How often do you spray neem to your seedlings? I would say do this as part of your watering routine. I would apply like once a week up to 2 months. Now, the best time to transfer the seedlings is 2 months. During that time, you're going to use different products during the transfer. You're going to use the Mycoplas. This Mycoplas is going to protect the seedlings against transplant shock and also protecting the root system of the seedlings against pathogens and giving that strong roots. So let's go ahead and transfer our papers. We use the microgreens soilless media, but you can use any kind of potting mix, guys. I just love this soil because it has these small particles of perlites and vermiculites. You can see, and I'm using the new pot. So if you are using a used pot, of course you have to disinfect the pots because you don't want to introduce pathogens. So just fill half. So after I place the soil, I add this worm dirt. The worm dirt is going to give nitrogen to my paper. So when you transfer the seedlings, be careful not to injure the roots. So use your both hand and then just pinch the bottom while pulling the other hand. So there are two seedlings here. I might probably remove the other one. So once you have your seedlings, use the Mycoplas and you just need one pinch and sprinkle onto root. This is going to protect the root against that fungus and then place in the pot. After you place the seedling, add extra soil. This is the Carolina Reaper guys, and have to make sure this plant is healthy. And I'm going to show you guys the papers that I applied the worm dirt. I want to show you how big the plant grows. So that's it. I grow koi fish in my greenhouse, so I use the water from the fish tank. So allow the water to drain. Now after you transfer this into the pot, you're going to place the seedlings in a filtered light because you don't want them to put too much stress. So that's how you transfer the seedlings, guys. And then keep in mind that when you transfer this plant, you don't need to place them in under direct sunlight. You don't want to add too much stress. So I keep it in here in the greenhouse, and the sun is filtered, so this is good for them. Now if you grow the seedlings in your house, indoor, So you are going to acclimate the seedlings because that hardening off. So you do this in 1 week. You take out your seedlings and then for a few hours outside and then bring it back until they get used to that full day of sunlight. Also, I'm going to follow up you guys with my bitter melon. Look at this bitter melon, guys. This is the bitter melon that I germinated in this GP plug. You see that? So I place it in here because it's a good companion. The aphids is this geranium is good for aphids, so they don't bother the aphids. So it is great to place my bitter melon here. Now I'm going to show you the paper that I grow, and I use this worm drug. Alright, so these are the papers, guys, Carolina Reapers. And if you guys need Carolina Reapers, check below this video. We probably place these plants this week. So keep an eye on our video. At the end of the video, we will put links and place this on eBay. So look at that, it's already blossoming. So this is the result of the worm dirt. It's too much nitrogen, that's why it's producing too much leaves. And what is funny, guys, the same plant I placed, the same plant that I took video on, I have this plant. Look at that, I place in the aquaponic raised bed. This plant grows bigger, and as you can see, the Carolina Reaper, this plant grows big because I place in a bigger container. And as you can see here, look at that, the bunch of flowers in here, and they like the aquaponics because they have this water, constant supply of water, so it's blooming like crazy. And I place my geranium in here close to that. So beside my yellow sticker, I place the geranium. It's one of the beautiful companion plant to place in your papers. So these are my papers I germinated in the aquaponics system. These are different type of paper. This is red paper Peter, and it has this unique weird characteristic of fruit. And I haven't seen fruit like that, so I thought it would be fun to grow this paper. And all of these seeds are germinated. What is great about using this system is that you don't have to worry about watering, and the system is supplying that water to the plant, and your soil is media is constantly moist. So I would encourage you guys to use this system. Get the system in Amazon. I will put the link in this video and check the link, because it is a great system, gardening method. And I see few gardeners using the system for growing salad. I don't use my system for growing plants or vegetables. I use that for propagation only. So either I propagate seeds or propagate cuttings. But again, you can use that for growing greens. So after I removed my seedlings from the system, I started germinating seeds. Look at that. Look at the seeds. It's so cute. Look at that. They are happy. I also recommend for you guys, probably some of you use worm casting. So this is great. What I do here, when I grow my vegetables, I fill the container halfway, and then I fill in 1 cup of worm casting and place the plant on top of it, and then add another soil. And if you do that, your plants grow bigger and taste better. So my paper was doing great, and right now they're producing too many blossoms. So I already applied worm casting in these papers. I place couple, and I probably introduce a foliar spray. You can also use the worm casting, guys. You can brew the worm casting for 24 hours. That's what we do here in the garden. we brew our worm casting, so you can apply the, you know, the solid form. You can also apply the liquid form. So we make foliar spray. So I'm going to apply foliar spray with this plant. All right, guys. So this is the video for today. It's a quick video, and just to follow up with you with the germination. So when you germinate the seeds indoor, make sure that you do the acclimation. Don't place that outside for too long because they are not adjusting the environment yet. So you have to place it for a couple hours and then bring it back. Then do it for 1 week. So thank you for watching, guys. This is Marceline at Cashier Greens. Stay green, grow big. Peace out.